5 W's and 1 H.
Who?
Susan B. Anthony and Elizabeth Candy Simpson. What? They were activists who were fighting for equality and the rights for women to be able to vote. Where? The United States of America. When? Women's suffrage began in 1776, when Abigail Adams wrote to her husband, John Adams, saying, "Remember the ladies," and ended when the 19th Amendment was written in 1920. Why? Women's suffrage started because women felt that it wasn't right for women to have the rights to vote, and they also wanted equality. How? The activists protested to get the word, and they also got arrested.
Causes and consequences. Women didn't have the equality or the right to vote, so they protested. This got them arrested. How, you ask? Well, to be more specific, activist Alice Paul was one of the women who weren't allowed to vote. She protested in front of the White House, and the president, Woodrow Wilson, put them in jail for obstructing traffic. In jail, they did the cause of not eating until women were allowed to vote. They were force-fed. This news about hunger strike attracted the public, and Alice Paul got the consequence she wanted, which was getting the public attention. Since the women kept fighting and never gave up, they got what they wanted, and the 19th Amendment was written. Yes, the women kept fighting, and actually because of this, it changed half of the people's mind who didn't want women to be equal. And 100% of those people were men. But it took one man named Henry Burns, whose mother left a message saying, "Be a good boy and vote for women's suffrage," to allow the amendment to take in place. He voted yes, and the amendment was signed.
Women's suffrage is civil disobedience because they broke the law of moral belief. Because they didn't think that it was a right that women, it wasn't right that women weren't allowed to vote. They did it publicly by protesting so that the word about women's suffrage would get around. The women were also aiming to change the law so that women were allowed to vote. The women were also nonviolent because the government beat them and forced them and force-fed them. They let them without fighting back.
The women's suffrage movement was started by a few strong women who wanted to have political, economic, and religious equality. The first National Women's Rights Convention was held in Worcester, Massachusetts in 1850 and was held every year until 1860. In May 1869, the National Women's Suffrage Association was formed to accomplish billing rights. The organization was formed by Susan B. Anthony and Elizabeth Cady Stanton with the main goal of political, economic, and religious equality. Lucy Stone and Henry B. Blackwell created the American Suffrage Association, which only concentrated on getting the women the right to vote. Thanks to both of the organizations, Wyoming became the first state to pass a women's suffrage amendment in only a year. In only a year, women were able to serve in juries there. In May 1860, many other states followed Wyoming and distinguished the women's suffrage movement's efforts. The two organizations later combined and became the National American Women's Suffrage Association, which brought them even closer to their goal of equality and women's right to vote. It took years for the states to follow Wyoming's lead and pass a women's suffrage amendment, and by 1896, more states started to pass the amendment. There were still many states that didn't pass the amendment, so women kept fighting. In 1920, after coming down to one vote in the state of Tennessee, the 19th Amendment to the United States Constitution secured the vote for women. On August 26, 1920, the 19th Amendment was signed into law by the Secretary of State, Bainbridge Colby. The 19th Amendment states that the rights of citizens of the United States to vote shall not be denied or abridged by the United States or by any state on account of sex.